This episode of DNews is brought to you by LG G3.
Could saving information digitally be expanding our minds? Hi everyone, Crystal here for DNews. Have you ever felt terrible? Really terrible for forgetting something? A birthday, a passport, an appointment? Maybe forgetting has had negative consequences for you and your relationships. People that tend to remember facts and details and recall them on short notice can appear more intelligent, and these traits are often praised and highly valued. As we grow up, we're taught through experiences, both positive and negative, that being forgetful is a bad thing. But scientists at the University of California, Santa Cruz are asking us to take a deeper and more scientific look into the adaptive benefits of forgetting. The authors of a paper published in Psychological Science recently proposed that forgetting allows us to reallocate cognitive resources away from maintaining old, potentially irrelevant information and focus instead on remembering new information. This might free our brains up to be more responsive to our environment in real time. So how do we make room for new information without the negative consequences of forgetting our mother's birthday or the names of the new boss's kids? Well, technology, of course. Our external hard drives, be they digital records, handwritten lists, or long-suffering moms and girlfriends who remember details for us and keep us on track, function to expand our minds and allow us to hold on to information without impairing our ability to access the full store of our working memory. This might seem like a no-brainer. After all, if you're like me, your Google Calendar has been running your life for the past few years. But now scientists are taking a deeper look at the seemingly intuitive phenomenon and asking questions about how technology and our confidence in the saving process facilitates our ability to create new memories. Researchers asked 20 college students to use a computer to open and study pairs of PDF files, cleverly named File A and File B. Each file contained a list of 10 common nouns, and students were told that they'd be tested on their ability to remember those lists. After 20 seconds of studying File A, they were asked to close the file. They then studied File B for 20 seconds and were immediately tested on how many File B nouns they could remember. The key to this study is that half of the students were told they could save File A to a particular folder before opening File B. The other half of the students were simply told to close the file. Unsurprisingly, the students remembered more words from File B when they had saved File A instead of just closing it. This implies that knowing that the information in the first file was saved somewhere allowed them to forget that information and free up more working memory for the list of nouns in File B. Additional trials revealed that the perceived reliability of the saving process of File A affected the subject's ability to remember content from File B. So when students were told that saving File A might not work, there were no saving-related memory benefits. So we have to have confidence in where we're saving our information in order to release that space in our short-term memory for new stuff. The researchers conclude that offloading memory onto the environment actually helps us learn and remember new information, but only if we trust the place where we're storing our info. So I guess, in a way, those smartphones and other assistants that seem like an extension of ourselves really are. And a trusting partnership, at least with technology, is allowing us to expand our individual abilities and hopefully be smarter. After all, as Einstein said, the value of a college education is not the learning of many facts, but the training of the mind to think. Where do you save your offloaded memory? Let us know in the comments down below. And you can also come find me on Twitter at PolyCrystalHD.
This episode of DNews is brought to you by LG G3.